Hello, I'm Mark Hoffman, Chief Investment Officer for Fulton Financial Advisors and Fulton Private Bank. This past month saw no shortage of headlines to discuss. The 2024 presidential election is now in full swing. There were headlines on inflation and interest rates, and the stock market had a big rally. Let's start with the election. The early polling shows another tight race for the White House, and there's a long way to go to Election Day in November. With all the ways this election is unprecedented, there's no way to know who's going to come out on top when all the votes are in. However, our research shows that even if we knew who would win, that would not tell us much about how the economy or the markets would perform over the next 4 years. We've looked at GDP growth and the stock market under every president since Dwight Eisenhower, and we've found no correlation between which party controls the White House and economic growth or stock market returns. The truth is that presidents and their policies usually don't drive the economy in the short run. Economic trends across administrations and world events play a much bigger role. So when we think about investing, it's important to set aside our partisan preferences and focus on the data to make the right investment decisions. Turning to that data, we believe the economy remains strong. Current estimates of GDP growth for the first quarter show a slowdown from the second half of 2023, but a still strong 2% growth rate or better. Job growth continues to be robust, averaging over 250,000 new jobs per month over the past 3 months. The unemployment rate did tick up to 3.9% in February, but other data still points to a strong labor market. The employment rate for prime-age workers ticked back up and is above the pre-pandemic peak in 2019, and layoffs remain near historic lows. Shifting gears to inflation, the story is more complex. Reported inflation, as measured by the CPI index, was meaningfully above the Fed's target in January and February. But we think this is more likely due to quirks in the data than a sign of re-accelerating inflation. First, remember that the Fed targets a different measure of inflation, PCE, which is broader than CPI and has a much lower weight to shelter. And shelter tends to overstate inflation when inflation is declining. Second, even PCE inflation came in higher than hoped for in January, but it's worth noting that inflation measures in January frequently look high due to many prices getting reset at the turn of the year, even after seasonal adjustments that try to account for this effect. In 20 of the past 25 years, January's inflation estimate was higher than inflation turned out to be for the full year. We always knew that there would be some bumps along the way, so the recent data is within expectations. We'll be looking for inflation to return to normal levels this spring. That said, the most recent data has given some on the Fed pause, and now markets think the first Fed rate cut will likely be pushed out until July. We don't believe the date of the first cut is a major driver for the economy. If there is a deterioration in the job market or the growth outlook, we believe the Fed has room to cut rates sooner. All in, it's been a busy month. But the best path for investors has been to stick to a well-designed, long-term plan. There will no doubt be many days with bold headlines in 2024. But investors who stay disciplined, focused on the details, and stick to their plans are likely to come out ahead. Thanks for listening. I look forward to speaking with you again next month. I'm sure there will once again be a lot to talk about.